In this video lecture, we want to go over the conditional operator in Java, which can provide an alternative to certain kinds of simple if-else logic. Okay, let's get started. The conditional operator is a shortcut operator in Java, which can be used to simplify certain cases of simple if-else logic. It's kind of an oddball operator, and in a precedence table it looks just like this, a question mark and a colon together. Interestingly, it's Java's only ternary operator, which means it requires three operands. Every other operator we've seen has been either binary, taking two operands, or unary, having only one operand. The syntax of the conditional operator looks like this. Note up here that with two symbols, we have positions for three operands, here, here, and here. Before the question mark, we have the first operand, some conditional expression. After the question mark, but before the colon, we have the second operand, some true expression. And after the colon, we have the third operand, some false expression. When we have such an expression involving a conditional operator, it's just an expression and cannot stand alone as a full statement by itself. In fact, you'll notice the absence of a terminating semicolon here. However, this can be used within some full statement as part of a larger expression, or perhaps for variable assignment. The way a conditional operator works is simple. First, this condition is evaluated, which of course yields one single Boolean value. Then, if the condition is true, then this true expression is used as the value for this entire expression. Otherwise, if the condition is false, then this false expression is used as the value for this entire expression. Again, this entire expression reduces to one single value. The conditional operator can be used to more compactly represent specific simple cases of if-else selection logic. Here on the right, we see two versions of code for the same selection logic that are functionally identical. I've used color here to emphasize the equivalences. On the top, we have some simple if-else logic. Some condition is evaluated, and the value of some resulting variable var is set to one expression if true, or to another expression if false. On the bottom is the same identical logic expressed with a conditional operator. The value of this entire right-hand side expression is either this true expression or this false expression, depending on the value of this condition, and that value is assigned as before to this variable var. Both ways of doing this are functionally identical. Some folks prefer the compact style of this conditional operator, others prefer the more readable style of this if-else. In the end, it's just a matter of personal preference and coding style. The conditional operator is a bit weird at first and takes a little getting used to, but it can be nice in certain situations. Some examples of these might be handling invalid inputs, outputting similar messages, or as shown here, initializing a variable to one of two possible values. If using a conditional operator, bear in mind that its precedence is very low, as we'll see on the next slide. The conditional operator is an operator in its own right, and as such, occupies its own place in an operator precedence table, as we see here, where the conditional operator is highlighted for emphasis. Again, remember that these two symbols taken together constitute one operator, no different than the OR, AND, equal equal, or plus plus operators. The main thing to note here is the relatively low precedence of the conditional operator, meaning that any of these other operators within a conditional operator expression would get evaluated first. But then that conditional operator expression would be evaluated before being assigned to some left-hand side variable using one of these assignment operators. To see the conditional operator at work, I'm going to refer you now to the following two source code examples and their associated code walkthroughs. Please take a moment now to open these files in JGRASP and follow along with the walkthrough videos. You'll find them all in the usual places. SelectionConditional1.java demonstrates a grade calculation message using both if-else and a conditional operator. SelectionConditional2.java demonstrates computing an absolute value in three different ways, using if-else, a conditional operator, and in a preview of coming attractions, an available math method. So to sum up, you don't have to use the conditional operator if it feels clumsy right now. Standard if-else logic will work just fine, but I just want you to know what it looks like and that it's there if you want to use it.